Believe in me. Welcome back to Fish and Drifts, guys, and we're back into it.
At Brayton Park.
Today's episode. Trailer is getting a bit of a makeover, a tie rack, because the patrol has been sold. It's gone.
Yeah, long gone. It's 3 months now.
Yeah, it's been a while.
And Red Rocket's gone.
Red Rocket's gone, and we used to put all the tyres in the back of the tray.
And now we've got another Red Rocket.
Another Red Rocket is on its way. So in recent times, I have bought a new four-wheel drive, which is on its way up from Victoria. And it doesn't have the space in the back that the old Red Rocket Patrol had. This is the steel we've got to work with at the moment. Jeffrey scooted up the Rocky the other day and brought back some 40 by 40 mil box. And just went to Bunnings before, got some 50 by 50 mil box. And we got some, what are these called? Linchpins or something like that. We're into it about $100 of material at the moment. I know Bunnings has a bit more 40 by 40 up there, so worst comes to worst, buy another length or two.
We need a length or two, we're going to build a new trailer.
Mate, if you want a length or two, I'll... We're not doing your traditional. Boom, over the top. So I know a lot of drifters, they have the over the top style, and it will end up being up here, which my shoulder in recent times isn't made for putting, you know, 8 wheels up here. I've got to look after my shoulder as best as I can. And also, what I've noticed, I think it was Joel's Jiggies, he got the tie rack up there. And by the time we got to wherever we were going, say Townsville, whatever it was, all the dust, the brake dust, had water, condensation, whatever, leaked down on the wheel, and it comes down onto the white car and just leaves black marks all over the white car. Thanks to Josh from Norrie Factory, eh? Lend us the old... drop saw.
And why is that?
Because Bunnings had no 300 mil cut off blades for my drop saw. Ready to tack. Tack it up in place. Got our mounts there sorted. The old linchy pins, a good idea there, Jeff Arena. Overall is 2360. This is 2400, so 20 mil each side overhang. Right. Yeah, right there. How good is that? On. Have a grind on that. Back the dog. Oh, ramp her up.
It's only 2 mil thick.
Ramp her up. Yep. Turn her up. Up. That ain't well good. One, two. We've got to work out
angles.
Yeah, so obviously the
don't wheel... put that on there because your world's a shit house. It tacks.
Hey, they're just holding tacks. They'll hold in place.
Yeah, and you're pushing all the way backwards.
Believe in me. For once, believe in me. That overall is 630. Welcome back to the ship pumps and S15s. There's the ship pump. Look what we have here, one tonner, eh?
So.
New to the channel, mate. New to the channel. So what we're gonna do, turn this into the next speedway car. Oh, big dog, eh? And he went to the gym this morning.
Oh, well.
You don't muck around, eh?
No, well, by the time we push it down there and it rolls down the street.
Yeah.
And then we have to go fetch it.
Yeah.
Go to the top if you can.
Yeah.
Roll it down a touch.
Yep.
Looks like you're building wings for your boat trailer. You stop the rocks hitting the car.
Oh yeah, well, how good's that? It's gonna act as that as well.
Hmm.
Whilst I'm going to high production, mate, doing these, eh?
Not with our dodgy skills.
Well, looks good now. Probably won't look good 200k down the road and in four pieces.
We've got a wheel in, and this is the biggest wheel I got, which is a 11-inch wheel. And from what we're working out, we can get four in each side. So we're going to split the center now because of the winch. Have a bit of a gap through here, and then the winch rope can go through.
Originally we were going to make legs out to the corners here.
Yep.
We were going to kick them out 30, and 30 back down.
That won't work.
Nah. Well, it probably would work, but what we're now just going to do is put weld it in here, flush with the bottom of this rail, and just go centre mount.
Yeah.
And see how it goes. Should and, still be stable enough.
And we should be still be able to take it out of the trailer.
And sit it on the ground.
And sit it on the ground. And then use the tie rack.
As a tie rack.
As a tie rack in the shop too.
Yeah.
Oh, happy days! Hee-hee. Get on welding!
I can't see if we're square.
Have a go! Yeah, boy!
Fuck ya.
It's holding it, but it's not great.
All right. Up it goes! Bop.
See? We need you to cut it straight.
Right, watch it, watch it. Spot on, mate. What do you got?
I don't know.
Slot her in. Oh, mate.
Look at that.
Look at that.
Oh, it's fucking hot.
Yeah. I wonder why. And look at that, at least. We're gonna go up, go up.
You wanna go to the top?
I reckon, yeah, so then it braces everything up then.
There we go, look at you go.
But it looks cool as well. You know, you got the nice angle there on the trailer.
Boat wings.
Yeah, and then and this will stop the rocks off the back wheels hitting the car as well, so.
Yeah.
Two birds, one stone.
Yep.
Well, hopefully no stones.
Hopefully no stones.
That's it. Drill some more holes here. A
few more tacks, then pull it off and zip it up. Look at that, he's got his holes straight.
Yeah, you know, straight enough, hey? Gone from doing six spark plugs to boily, like mechanic one day, fab boy the next.
Still not a fisherman.
What? So brain surgery tomorrow. Don't know who wanted me or Jeff, but one of us.
Dirty up that rear bar with a strap across there.
Just a bit of a leg brace.
Bit of a leg brace, that's it, eh? And then we'll get it out now and make sure it sits nice and flat on the ground.
Yep. So old mastermind Palmer actually pulled it off. Have a look at this. Let's show you his handiwork.
Ta-da! There we go, eh? So on the ground it works. Obviously it comes off, got them four pins, pull the pins out. Even one person can take it off. It's that light. Nothing to it. And then we're thinking, I might tip over with one wheel on there, but how many times are you gonna have one wheel? But still, it's maybe if you give it a push it'll knock over, but other than that, that's happy days, Jeff Arena. He's gonna fully weld her up.
Sand it back.
Give her a coat of pink.
Pink.
Hey.
Everyone loves some pink bits.
Yeah, that's it, hey. Some of that fluoro pink. Woo-hoo.
Collects pink.
Hey.
But absolute no measurements other than 2400 mils to start off with. Everything else has been guesstimation and it somehow works as you will get V-rolled right now.
The old fluke, eh? Beauty. We're going to wrap up that video. You've got the gist of what's going on here with the tie rack. Now I'm just going to lay some nice welds, I hope, to finish it all off, and we'll get it painted. and we'll update you on another episode later on down the track.
All freshly painted, all ready for FGP.
Yeah, that's it, eh? So yeah, this is what we're all getting ready for. RevGP, and Jeff's got the Speedway in Rocky coming up as well.
28th of October.
Yep, so we're gonna get the trailer ready, gonna get the cars ready, and we're off, we're racing again.
Yep.
Like, comment, subscribe, see you in the next one.
Yeah, buddy.
Three speeds, boy. Kiss the wee.
Fuck it.
There, beauty. And the meat there. Get around there, Jeffrey. We're gonna throw a sick weld on there, right? Just don't know he's doing the sick welds yet. If you want one of these, we're making kits now. Head to fishanddrifts.com.au.
Bullshit.
No, go to the website and get yourself a t-shirt or a hat. Hey, gangster. Hey, Jeffarina. What are you looking at?
My stress levels?
Oh, you got the thing on the wrist. Oh, out the roof.
Peeking out, being with you. All afternoon, peaked out. Look, you match my same intensity while I'm at the gym, peeking out for the rest of the day.
Well, you know how much money I'm saving you from going to the gym?
None.
Hang out with me, look at that. Look at the workout you're getting.
You know there's such thing as a measuring tape, right?
We've gone this far without one. Believe in me.